bishop. A lot of people think that bishops are those that orchestrate over different ministries. But bishop, the Hebrew term, is just a spiritual leader. See, I want to cut up some religious bondage that we may not understand. A bishop, if you look it up in the Hebrew text, it means a spiritual leader. Because what God does here is he corrects and encourages. Amen. Hallelujah. If we can take the good stuff, amen. Somebody say I can take the chastisement too. Amen. Praise God. So it's just not, amen, hallelujah, that I'm doing something because I'm trying to prove myself to another. But I'm doing it out of the obedience of God. Amen. Watch this. Amen. Meaning not quit the anger. Hallelujah. Somebody try to come and tell you the truth. Amen. And you want to get angry. Amen. Hallelujah. You mad. Amen. Oh God, he's going to step on my toes right now. You mad because they told the truth. Amen. But you didn't like what type of truth they told. Amen. Because your standard was, well, why in the world did you do that? You know better. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm trying to tell you the truth. But you are too concerned about what I've done instead of trying to help me in a place where I can get stabilized. Anybody can touch and agree with me today. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, I did wrong. Yes, I was wrong. Hallelujah. But can you get over the offense? Amen. So we both can get free. Because if you've been carrying offense, and I said it the other week, for 20 years, then baby, you need some deliverance yourself. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Can we talk about it? See, what this is saying, people don't understand. There is nothing the matter with drinking wine. It's when you abuse it. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, I know people don't teach like this. I'm a step, amen, forward a little bit. It's nothing the matter with consuming wine. Amen. I didn't say consuming gin and juice.
Amen.
Oh, y'all like this? Can I talk to y'all like this? I didn't say gin and juice. Oh, can I break it down to you? Amen. Gin and juice got a lot of manufacturing to it. Amen. Hallelujah. It's not been purified by nature. All wine is just grapes. Amen. And if God didn't want you to have it, believe me, he wouldn't have created it for the wedding. Amen. Praise God. It's all right that you can drink wine, but when you abuse it, amen, it's all right when you drink a soda, but it's when you abuse it, stuff begins to happen. Amen. Somebody better catch this in the spirit. See, it's when we abuse it. It's all right for you to take some medication, but when you abuse the medication, that's when it becomes a problem. Amen. And some of us, because we don't know the purpose of something, amen, we will abuse it. Amen. Hallelujah. You don't know the purpose for your wife, so you abuse your wife. You don't know the purpose for your husband, so you abuse your husband. You don't even know the purpose for yourself, so you begin to abuse yourself. Amen. You gotta understand purpose in order to operate correctly. Amen. Somebody ought to catch this in the spirit. And some of us, if we tell the truth, amen, you've been abusing yourself. Amen. Hallelujah. You've been speaking calamity over yourself. Amen. You've been in this rut because of your own mind. Can we talk about this today? Amen. Because every time, amen, hallelujah, somebody asks you how you doing, you got a list of sickness that you got. You want God to work through that? You want God to work through your mouthpiece? Well, tell me what you speak in life at. Because God works in living things. Not in the dead things. We constantly speak over our life unaware. Amen. And this is why some of our households can't get it together. Because your deadly tongue. Oh, you think God just talking to you? Amen. I'm part of this too. Praise God. Because of your deadly tongue. Because of your standing. Move your standing and let's pick up God's. It says the lover of good men. Amen. They might not just be righteous yet.
Amen.
They might not be righteous yet. They got to get to that point. Amen. Hallelujah. Because some of you think that you can make yourself righteous. No, that's something that's been bestowed through Christ. Amen. Through God. Amen. He puts the righteous on the inside of you. So if you were thinking that you can make yourself righteous, you already done messed up right there. Amen. Hallelujah. Because we don't make ourselves righteous. Amen. Hallelujah. It is God that pours his righteousness in you. But let me tell you how he poured in you. You got to want it. You got to want the righteousness. Amen. You got to want to be holy. You got to want to be consecrated. The Lord says, whoever asks for the Holy Ghost, I'll give it to him. You want him? But some of us understand that if I'm going to be righteous, I got to let some stuff go.
Come on, Spirit.
Some of us understand.
righteousness, that means I gotta let some stuff go. I gotta let some conversations go. I gotta let some way that I think, I gotta let that mess go. Some way that I respond to people, I have to let it go. Some things that I do, I gotta let it go if I'm gonna walk in righteousness. And some of us ain't willing to let some stuff go. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the Lord says that you have to love a good man. He's a good boy, but he's overtaken by this thing. It's a good woman, but she's overtaken by this thing. But I'm going to be patient. And I'm going to keep exercising truth. Because my faith says one day.
Come on.
Say it, sister. One day. One day. Yeah, I've been waiting for a long time. One day. Hallelujah. Elizabeth waited a long time. She waited a long time for what God was going to put in her womb. Somebody better catch this in the spirit. And I'm going to say it. Some of you think you're up in age. And the Lord said, I still got a purpose for you. She waited a long time to birth what was coming out of her. And what she birthed was phenomenal. She birthed the armor bearer. The one that prepared the way for our Lord. And hear me. Sometimes you got to wait a long time on what God want to put inside of you. And if we can be patient with God, amen, it's going to be worth the wait. Some of you said, I've been waiting on marriage. It's going to be worth it, baby. Stay patient. I've been waiting on a career change. It's going to be worth it. Stay patient. I've been waiting on my family to change. It's going to happen. Stay patient. But what I loved about Elizabeth, regardless of her circumstance, I'm old. I have expired when women birth kids. I'm old. But if a supernatural angel can come and visit me and tell me I'm old, then that's what's going to be. I don't care what doctor said. I don't care what you say. I don't care how long you say that I've been in this mess. Amen. Hallelujah. My God said he's going to set me free.
Amen.
So if my God said it, I don't have time to argue with your doubt, because that's not my doubt.
Amen.
Your faith is not my faith. Amen. And I'm not going to debate with somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. When I raise the bar and you taking your weights and dragging my faith down. No. Hallelujah. To let you be, sugar, because God can show you better than I can tell you. I understand what you're saying, but amen, hallelujah, I need a miracle, just as the days of Jairus' daughter. You're talking all that mess, and my child is trying to be resurrected. I gotta put you out.
Yes,
I gotta put you out, because you're about to mess up. You're about to mess up the miracle that I've been petitioning God for.
Come on.
So you got to go. Wait, what you doing? No, I can't listen to you. Yeah, them the folks you cut off. No. Cut their conversations off. Cut their deadly words. No, I cannot have you speak like that. Hallelujah. Because I'm expecting God to do something marvelous on the inside of me. And it ain't got nothing to do with age, gender. Hear me, people, God.
I told people this the other day. God ain't trying to change your personality. He loves your personality. Amen. He's trying to change your masters. He's trying to change who you serve. I had a big mouth in the streets. Ain't my mouth still big? I heard the woman of God say, you sound like you got a mic on the inside of you. I was built to do this. Amen. I was purposed to do this. Amen. And it ain't that I'm bragging. Amen. The Lord knew that my mouth could summon people in the world. Amen. And a crowd will follow me. So why can't I summon people in the kingdom and let them follow me to his will? Hallelujah.
Come on, the Holy Spirit about to wrap it up. Amen. Praise God. And look at this, people, God. In this last verse, he says this. He says, they, hallelujah, praise God. He says, they profess that they know God. Hallelujah. I'm in the shade back here. Amen. He says that they profess that they know God, but in works they deny him, having an abomination and disobedience, and unto every good work reprobated. Look at this, people, God.
Hallelujah. Spirit of the Lord working it up. Titus, I want you to understand, Titus was a follower of Paul. He was a follower of Paul. And because he was a follower of Paul, amen, he was being trained. He followed Paul in different periods in his life. You can look at Galatians and I think 2 Corinthians. You will see Titus, amen. He followed Paul. He followed Paul on different missionary journeys that he went on. And Paul was addressing Titus in this letter, amen. He was addressing him, and what he had assigned Titus to do was to go out after some Greek followers. Amen. And it was in a land that was called Crete. Hallelujah. And Crete was a large island off of the coast of Greece. Amen. And Paul wanted him to restore the order. He wanted him to begin to network with the churches there. Amen. Hallelujah. And and what we don't understand is that the Cretan culture, watch this people, God, this is going to be good to you. The Cretan culture was exercised widely through the Greeks. And one of the Cretan cultures was people, God, that they worship Greek gods. Amen. Hallelujah. And what they did, because they worship these Greek gods, Zeus, amen. Everybody's familiar with mythology. Amen. Hallelujah. Zeus was a Greek god that a lot of the Greeks worship. Amen. Hallelujah. So this culture was strong. But what they did was they brought Zeus into the church. They brought their false god, and they wanted to do similes. They wanted to compare and do these things in the church. And some of us are looking like, man, that's terrible, but we're doing it now.
Yeah. Yeah.
We bring all our pagan. Oh, y'all ain't gonna like me after this. Oh, Lord, I hope I get some sugar after this. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. We bring all our false worship in the church. We got Halloween coming up, and you can dress like witches and demons in the church. Oh, no, y'all ain't gonna like this. It's all right, because I'm here. Oh, God, somebody got twisted up, mad. Amen. Hallelujah. We can dress like witches and devils in the church. Oh, look at the little cute little witch. Oh, look at his little red horns. The Lord said, don't let carnality come into the church. It's scripture. It's here. You can do what you want. Man. And we're already doing it. You say, well, pastor, you're going too far. No, should I not? Because the job of pastors and leaders is to keep God's house consecrated and holy. Amen. And we don't like this. Amen. Let me tell you, I love the Halloween. I love a trick-or-treat. I loved all that back in the day. Amen. Hallelujah. Me and I was a big witch. She was a little witch. Can we deal with this? Or y'all gonna be mad at me? I was a little witch. And we had our broomsticks and we was, hallelujah, we was doing the thing, amen? Hallelujah, and then I began to study the word. I said, wait a minute, I like this holiday. See, it was a Greek culture. It was a Greek culture that they was adapting into the church. Not in the land, they was adapting in God's house. And we gotta be careful what we bring in God's house, because before long you don't know what's holy and what's not holy. Amen. You don't know what's permissible or permissible. It's in the Word. There are some things that we don't partake in. Now hear me. You say, well, Pastor, I've seen you celebrate. Yes, I celebrate the resurrection, whether you call it Easter, resurrection. We all don't heard the. I celebrate Christmas, whether you call it Christmas. But Halloween, I had to stop. And that was one of my favorite holidays in the United States. I had to stop it. When I began to learn the origin of what happens and what still happens today, I wasn't even going this route, but the Lord going here with me. When I learned the origin of what happens during this year and how it was created. Hallelujah. Listen, my daughter do cosplay out. Y'all probably see it on Facebook. They dressed in costume all year round. But Halloween, we don't. And you say, well, if they do it all year round, because there's nothing the matter with putting on costumes. Somebody better catch this. You wear costumes in plays. You wear costumes in the church. You wear all, there's nothing the matter with. But the origin of this holiday, when I realized that there are still people today, still witches and warlocks today, that take this day and they sacrifice, they steal animals. Guys, go Google it. Right now, we do it every year. We Google and go see how many animals are missing from the animal shelter.
You don't see a lot of strays running around? Yeah, somebody just said, I ain't seen, what, them cats was all in my backyard. I ain't seen them in a long time. Hallelujah. Listen, somebody better catch this in the spirit. Go and see, do the missing rate for children go up during this year? Go ahead. Nobody don't like to talk like this in church, but I'm going to do it. Go see, go do the research yourself and see, do the children rate rise up missing? Hear me. Hallelujah. And anybody needs this, you can Google me. Because I don't know why the Lord is going here. Amen. But I'm going to go here with him. Amen. There was a satanist and a profound, and I'm going to say profound, she was the head of the witch cult. Hallelujah. And these was two people. They have converted their life. If you want to go hear it, I'll give you the information. Shoot me a message and I'll give you the information to make a long story short. But she said during this time, what they would do was kidnap children. She said, but you had to break the child's spirit first before you sacrifice.
During this time. Are we quiet? During this time. Mm-hmm. During this time, you had to break the child's spirit. So they, you know how they broke the child's spirit? They did very sexual or moral things to them. Nobody, I know the church don't like to talk about this, but I do. And when I learned of the origin of Halloween, look at it. Hallow means holy. Ween means to take away. Even the name prophesies. Hallow means holy. Ween means to take away. Take away the what? Holy. Go and you'll find out so many stuff. I won't stay stuck on it, people, God, but you'll find out so many stuff. So I had to renounce that thing. Hallelujah. When I found out the origin of it, and you'll see, you'll have to do the research for yourself. And we do something that's called Harvest Fest here, where we give an outlet for the young people to celebrate. I'll give you all the candy you want. Hallelujah. We spray paint each other with, I'm surprised lightning bolts don't come down and strike us, because we have shaving cream on one another. We don't spray each other with shaving cream. We don't. One time somebody brought some pudding. I said, you're going too far. If you throw that chocolate pudding on me, it's going to be on. Hallelujah. We do all kind of stuff. We have all kind of fun and they tired. Hallelujah. But we give them an avenue and we teach them about the origin of Halloween. Listen, people, God, if we going to do this, we going to do it. Amen. If you're going to live for the Lord, you're going to live for him. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. And this is what I mean by some of us don't want to release some things. Amen. Some of us don't want to release some things, and I'm going to say it. Somebody going to get mad at me, but the Holy Spirit is wrapping it up. The Greek mythology, it was Greek. Some of our sororities that we are connected to, Greek. Oh, we don't want to hear this. Amen. Hallelujah. And you must do the study and the origin. And I know it's been in your bloodline for over and over again. But let me tell you about the spirit of witchcraft. Because when you join sororities that have, I'm not saying all sororities do. I said some of them. Go study, young people, what sororities you are joining when you go to these colleges. Because what happened, you'll see the evidence. Amen. If it's witchcraft, you'll see a bloodline. You'll see, amen, hallelujah, dimension in your family. Your grandma had it. Your great-grandma had it. You'll be, I can't remember this. Because the spirit of witchcraft is to attach to your mind. It begins to take particles of your memory away. I know some of you think I'm talking nonsense. But the Holy Ghost is going here. And I'm going to go here with him. And you think that, amen, God don't want you to participate in these things because he just don't want you to participate. He don't want you to participate because he know that the enemy have rights to certain part of you if you do participate. Hallelujah. Because it's his right. Why do you think that he had right to Job?
Come on. Jesus.
Somebody ought to catch this in the spirit.
That's right.
The Lord is not, amen, going to, hallelujah, do something that's out of his will. Job was dealing with a little bit of pride, and that's why the spirit of Leviathan was loosed on him. Amen. Hallelujah. But God made a declaration. Trial. But don't you take his life.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. And sometimes we'll try, amen, to make sure we understand about cutting some stuff out, people, God. And the Lord is going here. He's wrapping it up right here.
Yeah.
Some stuff you're going to have to cut out. I know you love it. Didn't I tell you I loved it? And I'm not just talking about a holiday. I'm talking about some actions that we are wrapped up in, sins that we're wrapped up in. And every time I say sin, people go to the sexual attributes. Sin. Sin is that you tell lies too much. All you do is lie for no reason. Why are you constantly lying? It's not even a purpose for you to lie. You exaggerate about things. You don't tell the complete truth, or you keep some stuff out. The Bible says all liars will have their place in the what? Like a fire. You're fearful. And somebody, listen to this, and he's going to wrap it up. Listen, when you're so fearful that you're ready to renounce God, the Lord says, all fearful, this is what it says, amen, go read it. All the fearful will have their place in the lake of fire. Some of you didn't know that even being in the act of fear when it comes to being challenged by what God wants you to do is a destination to hell. Hear me. Last thing. I had a testimony. Somebody came to me and they said, somebody came to me and said, Pastor, somebody wants you to marry them, but they don't want you to mention Jesus. Pretty sure that the money would have been prosperous. For me to say how much they paying, that would have been renouncing God. See, some of you think that renouncing God is to say, I don't believe in God. No, renouncing God is that you renounce the acts and the principles of who he is. Who constituted marriages? God did. So for me not to mention him, hallelujah, would be renouncing him. And hear me, I didn't even have to think about it. No. Now that may kill a friendship. It may make somebody not ever want to speak to me. Amen. Hallelujah. But hear me, I would turn my back on man any day before I turn my back on God. Somebody ought to catch this in the spirit. Praise God. Hear me, people, God. Hallelujah. I didn't go through the whole thing. Amen. Hallelujah. But I thank God hit it the points that he needed to hit. Hear me, loved ones. We have to understand. Amen. You come to church. Amen. No, you're not the one that's going to change yourself. The Lord is going to do it. But hear me. You got to get to a place that's going to exercise truth. Amen. That's going to exercise truth and get truth on the inside of you. Amen. Hallelujah. Because that truth is going to start working in you. Amen. Hallelujah. And you may dress like a goblin this year. You may dress like an angel. I'm doing an angel. Hallelujah. You may dress like a fairy. I don't know. Hallelujah. But one day you'll get it. Amen. And I'm not, listen, because I say something, I tell people, God, do not say, well, Pastor said we don't supposed to dress up for Halloween, so I'm not going to do it. That's purposeless. You should go ahead and do it. Do your research, and when you get the truth, that's when you start. Yes. You don't do something because somebody tell you to do it and you don't know and you're just following off of their instructions because maybe they might be wrong. Hallelujah. You go do your own research. And when you find out the truth, that's when you loose that thing. That's when you're going to see effectiveness in your life. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all. Let's bless them. Greetings, beloved. My name is Pastor Sharon L. Fields. I pastor Father's Vision Ministry. We would love to have you come out and fellowship with us. We believe that this is a spirit-filled place. We believe that the Holy Ghost speaks through us to empower you. Come on. Come and fellowship with us and get the word that you need today in order to have those principles in your life.